Hello everyone, it's Alvin Giroux of the Giroux Effect. Thank y'all for tuning into the Giroux Effect Live. Today we're at Skidmore Park in Saraland. We're at Jarrell Williams Skill and Fundamental Camp. We're from 3rd to 11th grade. I love events from the community, and I also love events for the youth. These kids are really tapping into their craft. We have tons of athletes out here. This is a great event. Thank you, Jarrell Williams, for throwing this event. As y'all can see, these kids are all around. They doing their thing. Let Coach Frosch out. Great event, y'all. Y'all stay tuned. Y'all tap in. I got tons of great interviews, and I have tons of behind the scenes of this great event. What's up, everybody? It's Alvin Giroux of the Giroux Effect. I'm back at the Skills and Fundamental Camp here at Skidmore Park. I'm here with...
My name is A.D. Diamond. I go to Auburn University. I graduated from Blount High School.
Man, A.D., so good to see you, dog.
Yes, sir.
You really are representing Mobile in a great way. Yes, tell them what college you attend.
Auburn University.
And what position you play?
I play cornerback.
A football player in the SEC. You came from Blount High School. Not too many people are going to the SEC. How's your experience of being on campus, being an athlete at Auburn University?
You know, it's just a blessing to be able to experience, you know, everything that comes with that. You know, it's just a blessing. Just be able to continue playing football at the highest level. You know, football, my biggest dream, you know. So it's just a blessing, you know, put God first and just thank Him for this blessing.
Great, man. You are a blessing. You're walking in your path. So look, I see that getting the leader out of you. You had a skills fundamental camp for the youth from 3rd to 11th grade. What are you doing today?
I'm just helping my boy, old former teammate Jarrell Williams with his camp, you know, in the city, give back to the youth. And we just here to, you know, give back and push these young kids to be the best they can be.
Yes, sir. I'm here with Armani Diamond. I'll be back with some more interviews on the way. All right, everyone. Thank y'all for tuning in to the Giroux Effect Live. I'm here with Mr.
Justin Roberson. Yes,
Justin Roberson, how you doing today, bro?
I'm doing good. How about you?
I'm doing good. What brought you here today at this game, the Fundamental Fair?
Jarrell called me out and said he wanted to help develop young kids and have a good camp. That's what he said.
So, man, as a leader, it's always great to impact the youth, the people behind you. So what are some things that you've been doing to impact your leadership and also impact you as a player?
I've been learning. I've been learning from some great players. And then I'm learning from them, so they're teaching me to develop, so I'm teaching them. Yeah.
Right, right. So what college are you going to?
I'm going to Alabama State. Yeah.
To play what position?
Safety.
DB. Safety. Yeah. Man, to play safety, you got to be a student of the game.
Yeah, like the quarterback of the defense.
For real. Yeah. What kind of player is Alabama State getting out of you?
Great player. I can't wait to get up there. Smart player. Just ready to get up there and be a ball hawk.
Well, man. What's going on, everybody? Welcome to the Giroux Effect Live. We're back with another interview. I'm here with the host of this camp. The dude, it's his vision. He's living his life. He's living his purpose. I'm with Jarrell Williams. How you doing, man?
Good, man. Thanks for having me on here.
Man, thank you for throwing this event, dog. It's a beautiful event. It's a beautiful day. We have tons of kids learning, grinding. And you leading a good example, man. It's always good to see us black men, us young black men, lead our youth and put them in the right path. So, to everybody, what's going on right now? What are you doing?
Right now, we're throwing a little football camp for the kids to come out here, get better, have fun on this beautiful Saturday. Just really want them to have fun, learn some of the game from some of us former high school athletes going to college. Just drop some knowledge to them that we picked up.
So the people who don't know you, telling them, what school you attend right now and what position you play?
I'm Jarrell Williams. I'm a receiver at the University of West Virginia. Or West Virginia University, I'm sorry. I played at Saraland High School all 4 years. So.
Man, so how has your experience been on college campus and grinding in a football program such as West Virginia?
It's a business. It's definitely, you have to work. They're really about the work, you know. Playing around, you gotta come to work every day and get things done.
So what's some words of encouragement, words of advice that you can give people under you right now who is trying to play on the collegiate level?
Keep working, your time will come.
Okay.
God has his time for you. You don't have to worry about it, he got you. Just wait your turn, it's coming.
For sure, for sure. One last thing, we always need that certain humility. We always gotta keep getting better, keep working. So what's something that you need to work on over this summer so you can be the best receiver that you can be in this next upcoming football season?
Speed's one of my big things. I wanna get better, get faster, stronger. I always need to get stronger. That's kind of my catching as well.
So your dad's been throwing football camps, basketball camps, athletic camps forever. So what brought you on to do an event like this, kind of under your dad's footsteps? What's something that is it something that he's kind of putting in your ear, or is it something that you really just wanted to do?
Just wanted to do it, knowing that I grew up in this life, doing camps and working out all the time. Just kind of want to give back to the kids that came out today and who may come in the future.
What's up, man? What's up? Great event. I'm proud of you. Keep doing what you're doing. We about to enjoy the rest of this camp.
Oh, yeah. Got to get these boys working.
Yes, sir. All right, everyone. I'm here with Connor, the author of the book, the dude who wrote it. This is his vision for real. He's really been doing a lot of great things for the community. He's done a lot of great things for me. He's impacted my life. I'm no longer in sports, but he's still vital. He plays a vital role in my life. And y'all see what he's doing for the community, with what he's doing for the kids, and also his sons. Great father, former athlete, coach, life coach, father of all, great man, a valuable man, a man who's giving value in our community, in his world. He's doing his thing. I really admire this man. I got Coach Fry with me.
Yes, sir.
How you feeling today, sir?
I'm good, man. I'm good. Talk to us.
Man, I love this event. Beautiful Saturday.
Yes, sir.
Kids grinding. Then you also teach them about God. Tell them the importance about having God in your corner as an athlete and just as a kid growing up in our community and growing up in this world.
Listen, man, when I started out, I wasn't able to go to the expensive camps. I had a man named Reverend Samuel Dansby. I just coached, took me to my first camp. It gave me the opportunity to learn about God and play the sport I love. I wouldn't be here if it weren't for Bibles and Balls, if it weren't for campus outreach, those FCA, all those type things poured into me. And so they use sports as a means to use our platform to reach the community, to reach the kids. So we just use that platform to make a difference. So I'm just trying to carry on the legacy that was given to me.
You doing it. So what's your vision in the next upcoming years for your academy and just for your camps and just for your son?
So it's like this. All these my sons, everybody that's coaching pretty much played for me or played with me or was on my kids' team. So the objective is to get them more exposure. We do camps, college outreach, and college exposure. And so community outreach and college exposure. So we just really just want to impact them in those three areas. You know, show them life outside of the sport and the sport. You know what I'm saying? We just want to use the sport to reach them. And then we teach them in the process. So the sport is like the bait, the real men. And then we teach them in the process, game of life.
All right, Coach. Thank y'all once again for tuning in to the Jarrell Effect Live. We have tons of great athletes, tons of great coaches, but also tons of great individuals. I'm here with
Coach Devontae.
Coach Devontae, how you doing, sir?
I'm doing well. How you doing today?
I'm doing good. So we had a great event. We in Sierra Land at Skidmore Park. What have y'all been doing today so far?
We've just been working with the young athletes, trying to get them better and perfecting their craft. One of the main things I focused on today was getting their 40-yard dash stance perfected. Being that I'm a track coach and having a track background, something we work with is the stance. The stance is very important with that 40-yard dash. Just speed in general, overall in football, is a very important aspect.
So what's some ways that athletes can just improve their speed and overall stamina?
The best thing is to stretch. Make sure that body is right. Get those legs strong. And just always just doing everything 100%. When you go to football practice, when you're doing things on the field, always do that 100%. That speed will build up over time.
All right. So, thank you for coming to this event. Thank you for looking out for these kids. Is there anything else you would like to say before we go?
I just want to say I appreciate Coach. I hope Jarrell is doing a great job up there in West Virginia, and I hope he continues to be successful.
Yes, sir. Thank you for coming to the show, man. Y'all are back on the Jarrell Effect Live. I'm here with somebody I've known for years. A great guy, a great athlete, a humble beast, a leader, a great young man. A great young man in our community, a great athlete. What's up, man?
What's up?
Look, tell everybody your name. What position you play?
I'm Bray Turner, and I play cornerback.
All right, what school are you going to?
I'm going to Northwestern University in Evanston, Illinois. Right, probably about 35 minutes from Chicago, downtown Chicago.
That's far from Odell.
Yeah.
What brought you to go over there?
My friend Jaylen had went up there, so he had told me it was a great brotherhood. I went up there and seen the campus, coaches, major coaches, it was just amazing. I committed on the spot right then and there.
Awesome, man. Awesome. So what is the work that you put in over this spring and also going into the summer so you can be a better player and better person?
Really just focusing on myself, just taking my weaknesses and making them strengths. I had shoulder surgery, so really just been working out in the weight room, trying to build my shoulder back up, and really just working on footwork and making sure when I go out there, I'm ready to condition. Because, you know, you can only prepare yourself. You can't, you'll never be ready for it, you know. They put you through things to, you know, to test you. So you just gotta be ready, mentally and physically.
What's up? So what's your role today?
My role today is just being a good leader, helping the kids get better every day, you know, being a good role model, let them just have fun.
What's up, man? Thank you for coming out to the show. Thank you for doing this today. Appreciate y'all enjoy it, man.
What's going on, ladies and gentlemen? It's Alvin Giroux, the Giroux Effect. We're at the Skills and Fundamental Camp here at Skidmore Park. I'm here with
David Caldwell.
And I'm here with
Brittany Zott.
So who are you working with today?
I'm working with the basketball tackles. We've been doing some ladder drills, hurdles, catching, working on catching out the backfield and using moves to make the defenders miss.
For sure.
We're with the quarterbacks, kind of working on drops, one step, three step, getting the ball out, making sure the receivers catch the ball once again.
Well, look, thank y'all for coming. Anything else y'all like to say?
Not really, I just want every kid to come out here and enjoy their time out here, and let's just get better.
Let's get better.
Couldn't have said it better myself.
All right, folks.